Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you here with us and pray you will be blessed. Sit back for the next 2 hours and enjoy while we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing, pray, and read the Bible in support of one another on our journey of faith. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer request and praise reports. You may call us at 606-464-4250 anytime during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Sister Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome into our studios. We're getting ready for another get-together with the Lord, and we hope that you have your work caught up to where you can just sit back and join with us. We can all worship Him in spirit, even though we're in different locations, you know, that it's in the spirit realm that we can do this. And so we appreciate all of you that join us each night, and we know some of you really look forward to it, maybe more than others, because you're not able to go to church. And right now, a lot of folk are not going to church because of this whole virus. But one of these days, it'll be over, and then will everybody be able to get back to church. Well, we want to start out tonight by honoring someone's birthday. Brother Emil Allen is celebrating his 93rd birthday today, and I talked to him and Karen just a while ago, and at 93 he got out and mowed some grass today. So if you need your grass mowed, just call Emil. He'll come and do it. But it's so good to know that he is able to get up and get out. And of course, he had a good riding lawnmower, and so happy birthday, 93rd birthday to him. He's been in the ministry for many years. They're wanting to get back over here, and so it probably won't be long. Someone else that's sick and waiting to get a little better, and that's Tim and Judy Ambergy. Tim's having quite a tussle with his lungs right now, so we want to remember him, and he said to tell all of you he loved you and wants to hurry back. And then also Brother Winston McClure, his brother has passed away, and the funeral will be tomorrow, so remember them. All right, we have some more prayer requests, but right now I have some scripture, just a few verses, just a very few, but these are so good. I love them, and because it tells us about an aspect of God that that maybe we don't think about too often. But in Lamentations, the third chapter, starting with the 22nd verse, it says, "It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because His compassion fail not. They are anew every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore will I hope in Him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for Him, to the soul that seeketh Him. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord." That's Lamentations, the third chapter, 22 through 26, talking about, you know, each day you hear lots of things that's happened to people in your area and people you know. But this reminds us, it is of the Lord's mercies that we're not consumed. And that is every day. That is every day, because we have an enemy, and he's God's enemy, and he tries to harass and buffet the Lord's people and do what he can, but he cannot win because he's already been defeated. But the Lord's mercy keeps us from going down every single day. And so remember that when you get up in the morning, just stop and say, "Thank you, Lord, for your mercies that you're going to be surrounding me, and I won't be consumed this day because that your love for him rules over all. All right, let's see. We have a couple of more prayer requests, and then we're going to have some or singing. All right, here's Jackie has called for Beverly. Something going on with her lungs, and so they need prayer for their neighbors also. And then Nellie Wooten, someone we've all known for a long time. Nellie used to come with the Montgomery Creek Express to sing, and she needs prayer for herself and for her brother Johnny and his wife Betty Ambergy. And she'd been in the hospital twice this week with chest pains, and they'd tried to call here, but you know, that was when we had tried to explain why we didn't have phones, because the phone company had it was on their end, something had malfunctioned, and said she always feels better when WLJC viewers pray for her. And so that's what we're going to do as the singers get ready to come. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your mercies that keeps us from being just wiped out of existence every day, because it's your love and your mercy. Mercy is something that we haven't earned, we can't buy, but it's your love in the form of mercy. And so we thank you for all of our friends that have joined in with us tonight, wherever they might be, and we ask for you to heal them and strengthen them, encourage them tonight, Lord. Pray that you will continue to bless Brother Emil Allen and help him to preach again, and for others, Lord, that need your help with their problems. Bless this group tonight, our phone operators, and Lord, we have so much to thank you for. Help us to never take everything for granted, but to stop and thank you for what you have already done for us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, tonight we have a brand new group with us, and I believe this is the first time they've all been here. It's Jason Smith and Blessed Friends, and that's from Vico, Kentucky, and they're from the Righteous Church of Jesus Christ, and also the Greasy Creek Holiness. And the phone number to get in touch with them is 606-276-9505, I believe that is. Five, is it? Okay. All right. They have several with them, and so this is our first time to meet all these people, so let's welcome the group right now to sing for us.
I'd walk with the Lord through sunshine and darkness. I cannot forsake. God knows all about us. understand what we're going through. Yes, He does. He understands what we're going through tonight. No matter what it is, if you take it to the Lord and cast it upon Him,
amen.
Praise God, He understands. Amen. I sung that song by request. I had a request to sing that song. You know, my sister-in-law, David's wife, she likes that song, so I send this song out to her. Send the whole program out to her and everybody out there that's watching.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. How many knows that heaven will be worth the journey when we get there?
Yes, it will.
Amen. It's going to be worth it all one day. Sometimes I get so weary traveling this old road that I cry, Lord, won't you come and help me carry this heavy load? But in the stillness of the night, He comes along and makes my Lord sing, oh, so high. Heaven will be worth the journey when I get there. You see, that's what we're here for. We're here to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen. We're here to sing for Him and lift up His name.
Amen.
Amen. I pray that somebody out there is watching this is getting the blessing out of this. Amen.
Oh, they said that He would come and the race, it would be wrong. It would be on an old rugged cross that they laid Him in the tomb. The power of God filled the room. He's alive and He lives forevermore.
Yes.
Hallelujah to the Lamb. That was slain on an old rugged cross. By His stripes we are healed, and by His blood we are sealed. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God.
Yes,
He's coming back someday, coming to take His church away.
Body is getting kind of feeble, and I just can't get around like I did when I was young and fair. But with eyes of faith, I see a brand new body that's waiting for me. I'll be young again when I get over there. I'll be young again when I get to heaven's shore. All the burden that I had up there I'll have no more. I'll never grow old again. I'll be young again when I get over there. Now sometimes these old hands are not as steady, and my steps are getting slow. There is silver in my hair. Oh, but I'm as happy as I can be, because I know what's waiting for me. I'll be young again when I get over there. I'll be young again when I get to heaven's shore. All the burden that I've had up there I'll have no more.
in this life we get old, we get tired, these old bodies does.
Yes, amen.
But you know what? If we got Jesus on our side, if we're born again and ready to go to heaven, we'll go to a place where we won't ever have to grow old again. You know, we done a funeral today, and you know, it was sad to see the loved ones hurt over their loved ones that's going on. But you know, there's coming a day in which all that's going to be over with, Jason.
Amen.
Amen. If we hold on to God, we'll get to see Him again. Amen. You know, this next song I'm about to sing, you know, I sung this today at that funeral, but I'm going to share it with you all today. I'm a winner either way, if I go or if I stay.
One knew he'd reach the end of life's journey, but he'd been holding to God's hand a long, long time. And as I knelt beside his bed, my heart was thrilled at what he said. If I go, I'm a winner either way, if I go or if I stay. For I have my Jesus each passing day. I'll have my healing here below, or life forever if I go. Oh, praise the Lord. Trust the Lord, He'll lead us safe to our reward, and by His grace we'll be a winner either way. I'm a winner either way, if I go or if I stay, for I still have my Jesus each passing day. I'll have my healing
side. We're on the winning side tonight. Amen. Amen. You know, that's what Paul said. He said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. Whether we live or whether we die, therefore we are the Lord's. Amen. We're a winner either way. We'll go to the key of A. How many need Jesus tonight? Amen. If you're watching out there and you need Jesus, amen, you need Him. Amen. Because without Him, we can't make it. Jesus is all that I need in this world, and He's all that we need out there. Amen.
Jesus is all that I need in this world. Jesus is all that I need. He's the one gonna stand by me. Jesus is all that I need. Take
We need him every day. I know I need him every day, don't you? Amen.
I got to go over to the pen or right now. All right.
It's all right. Amen. Jesus is the one friend that'll go with you all the way, even to the end.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So happy here to be lifting up the name of Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Amen. That's what it's all about.
There's a wide oak on the hill.
This is a favorite song of theirs. And all those in the nursing homes tonight that's listening, I visit quite a few nursing homes, and right now we're not able to go, but my heart goes out to them, and I'm praying for them daily.
Out on the hills of glory land, happy and free at God's right hand, tangled of a blaze through marvelous grace, called heaven's bride. And roll.
God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from His mighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for God we stand. Now see Goliath defying God's army, served a little David, but he did not stand alone. He said, in the name of the Lord I come against you. He slew that old giant with a sling and a stone. If God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from His mighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for God we stand. The lions were roaring, furious and hungry. Daniel knew the one he served would bring him out. The king cried, Daniel, has thy God delivered thee? He replied, the Lord has shut the lion's mouth. If God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from His mighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for God we stand.
There's so many religions in this world today. There's a church on every corner, it seems. Now everybody says they're going to go to heaven, but how to get there we cannot agree. I started my journey a long time ago. I'm not looking for anything new. My ticket was paid for on the old cross of Calvary. By the blood of the Lamb I'll go through. So I think I'll just stay in the old time way. It's the best way that I've found. I know that it's real by the way that I feel, since the love of the Lord came down. In a little old church by the side of the road, at an altar prayer I prayed through. So I'm going to stay in the old time way, and I highly recommend it to you. Now the way that I travel is straight and it's narrow, and oftentimes I'm tempted to stray. But faith keeps me going, there's comfort in knowing what awaits at the end of the way. You may not know me, you may not understand me, but I won't be changing my mind. So I'm going to stay in the old time way till I leave this old world behind. So I think I'll just stay in the old time way. It's the best way that I've found. I know that it's by the way that I feel, since the love of the Lord came down. In a little old church by the side of the road, at an altar of prayer I pray through. So I'm going to stay in the old time way, and I highly recommend it to you.
All right, thank you so much for all those songs, Jason Smith and the Blessed Friends from Vico, Kentucky. And we have some from the Righteous Church of Jesus Christ and the Greasy Creek Holiness Church. And this is their first time here tonight. We have a couple more folk in the audience, David Pennington and and I'm not sure what the other lady's name is, but anyway, we're glad to have these people. Well, I have my younger sister up here tonight. Most of you know my sister Shannon. She fills in for me when I have to be someplace else. She knows better than tell where I'm at, really at, so that's her nice way. So how are you tonight?
Well, all right, and I was thinking of Emil, his 93rd.
93, yeah.
And I was even telling him I'm still doing my job, taking pictures here, and I want to complain too, because they've been fussing at me. I drove to Richmond by myself, and I got up and changed a light bulb in my house. And they think just because I'm 92, I can't do that. But it didn't bother me, and I had fun all by myself. Oh. So she gave me a bunch of things to read, so I guess better. But I'm wishing Emil a happy birthday anyway. Right here, David. He's got kidney trouble, needs prayer. And Peggy, she wrote, pray for Jeff Noble. He's slowly improving. And pray for people on the unemployment. Now that's bad when you don't have any money. Pray for a sister needs guidance. Here's a lady from Corbin, had a car wreck and it totaled a car. I've done that once, and that's not a good idea. A long time ago, though. Phyllis from London, Mickey got new medicine. He's sleeping better, and pray for all the family. Right here's Shelby, been in the hospital and she's recovering, or called in by Shelby. Betty called in for Martha from Lee County, and here's a Placid County enjoying the singing, lady. And here's a lady from been having problems with her feet and legs, and they're swelling. And here, Betty called in from Lee County and needs prayer. So that's all I've got.
Okay. All right. Well, now, you heard what Shan said. She's been driving by herself, and she's been changing light bulbs in her house. So if you need some of this done at your house, just call her up. At 92, I guess she's old enough to make her own decisions. You think so?
Yeah.
But anyway, we can quarrel at her whether she listens or not. We can tell her that she should have had some help, but we're glad she's made it all right. From Casey County, Imogene has called for a daughter that she has the virus, and she's been quarantined for 10 days already. And we do need to pray for so many of these people that are still down sick with this virus, and that some of the churches are having to still stay out because that people in it has come down with it. From Lincoln County, there's several here, and said their mom had a hip, it's hurting real bad. Nelma from Whitesburg for Violet was put in a nursing home, not able to take care of herself anymore. Mary from Mount Vernon for her brother that's in a nursing home, and she needs prayer for a tumor that's on her spine, but all the blood work came back good, so that's good. Here's a praise report. A sister has called for a brother from Pike County, said he's doing better. And here's one from Adair County, and they have infection in the foot. And Mary from Estill County for Jimmy's had hip surgery and also foot problems. Oscar from Williamsburg having trouble breathing. And that's another thing people are suffering with right now. Tim Amberg said this is one of his big problems right now is not being able to breathe. And so there's lots of ailments that I haven't met anyone for a while that did not have something that needed to be prayed about. And so we're just all a needy bunch of people, and it's like that old song, it's me again, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. And I'm glad he doesn't get tired and say, well, you've called every day this week, and I'm tired, just leave me alone. But he wants to hear from us. That's what makes him so different from us. He wants to hear from us. He already knows what's going on, but he wants us to tell him and to come and receive help. From Rock Castle, here's a nice compliment about someone that likes to hear the Bible read every night here. Donald from Pulaski County for his grandmother. Corina from Morgan County for a sister-in-law that's had a heart attack. Lily from Rock Castle having difficulty with her back and also grieving over her daughter that has passed away. All right, we have, of course, we know there's a lot of you that did not get to call in. And now if you three preachers would like, ever have any back there, want to go back over to the mic stands, we'll send these requests over and let, here, take this. We'll let all of the preachers, here's, we'll let all the preachers gather in over there and pray. And, you know, I love to hear other people's prayers. I love to hear other people's faith, you know, turn loose on something. So here he's coming with them. And just pray for him. And pray for all the people that did not get through, because there's always people too sick to call.
All these needs before you, all these needs that's been mentioned tonight, these requests that's in our hands tonight, Lord, we bring these before you tonight. We pray for these that are sick in the hospitals, nursing homes, wherever they may be. Touch them and heal them. And we pray, Lord, for the lost souls, Lord. Get a hold of them and save them. We pray, Lord, your will be done, not our will, but thine be done, as we agree together. Reach each and every one out there tonight, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
All right. I believe we have time for you to tell, each of you tell where your church is located and the time of your services and so forth. One, two.
Our church is Greasy Creek Full Gospel Church. It's located 2 miles up in Greasy Creek, Leslie County. And our services are at 7 p.m. on Tuesday and 10 a.m. on Sunday. And if you got, you need looking for a place to go, we'd be glad to have you anytime. And we'll serve the Lord and seek him, and he has the answers. And, yes, you know, that's the God that we serve. Amen. You know, I got to say, You know, in this life we have, you know, a lot of advantages and disadvantages. And, you know, I've always been fond of saying that I'm probably not the sharpest knife in the drawer, or probably not the shiniest spoon on the table. But I do have one advantage. I believe in God. Lord, I believe in him. And I've seen him answer prayer after prayer. He's done so much for me, and I can't tell you how thankful I am for what God has done. And I believe that what he'll do for me, I know that he'll do it for anybody else. But thank God for a service tonight.
Amen.
I pastor the Lighthouse Church of Jesus Christ over Knox County, and right now we're having a church at the house. And but you can always follow us on our Facebook page, Lighthouse Church of Jesus Christ.
All right, so our singing group tonight has been Jason Smith and the Blessed Singers, and this has a VICO number here, 606-276-9505. And so you've heard the preachers tell where their churches are, and you can get in touch with them through that number. And then if you're hunting for a church, You know, there's so many churches around that it would really be nice to have all the churches come together and try to get along, because after all, we're all saved by the blood of Jesus, and we need to do this. Would be a good testimony. All right, we have from Harrison County, Laura, for Donna and Randy, both are in need of help. And from Fayette County, Jeremy is also in need of prayer. Those are two new ones, just came in. And but, you know, I'm always happy to know that people are looking to the Lord for your help. You know, a lot of times we kind of get following somebody, a person that you like. They have a good personality and, you know, friendly and everything, and you kind of, without realizing, you kind of grab a hold of their coattail and you kind of follow along. Sometimes if you follow too close, you can't see when they step out of line. And so that's why Jesus is our example. We should not try to follow any man, but we need to follow the Lord. We'll not be deceived. You know, over and over he said, make sure that we didn't let anyone deceive us. And so with the Lord coming back, we want to be ready, don't we? And so that's why we're here each night, and that's why the WLJC is even on the air, is to get the good gospel out. Shannon, do you have anything else you'd like to say?
No.
Can you come and change some light bulbs at my house?
Well, your ceiling is higher than mine. But I did it safe. I planned it all out, and I had a stepladder. It's a folding stepladder, and it had two steps on it, and it's got a back on it. Well, I know if I fell, I could grab that back. Or it was against the bed. If I fell, I'd land on the bed. So I had it all worked out, so it was safe. And then when I drove all the way by myself, see, my daughter said, did you go? I said, yeah. And then I started talking as hard as I could. She didn't ask if somebody went with me. That's what you do when you get old. Mm-hmm. You almost lie, but you're not telling a lie. They just didn't ask me.
Well, we'll know next time to look out that we'll either have to jump in, go with you, or you with us. But anyway, we're thankful the Lord's brought Shan through some. She got a pacemaker.
Pacemaker.
And it's just keeping her going. She's still, and you've got another great, great grandbaby,
yeah,
don't you?
My first fifth generation. She's 9 months old and walking, and every day I try to find a picture of her on Facebook. I don't know about Facebook, but I know when you punch that one little hand, it turns blue, and that's as much as I can do on Facebook.
Well, it maybe the baby is there. So, well, we're kind of running the race on how many great grands and so forth we can get. I already have six great greats, and another one's due either tonight, tomorrow, or Monday. And so it's going to be a little girl, and so we're all excited about that. And so I don't know if they'll find her in the cabbage patch or if the storks are bringing her. I'm not sure which delivery, but I was telling one of my little great-grands about she found a cabbage patch doll at my house, and she thought it looked really strange because, you know, it's an old doll that my kids had, and she couldn't figure out why its head was shaped like that. And so I was trying to tell her what people used to tell us when we was little, where they found babies, and she's just 5 years old, and she's shaking her head and said, said, they come from God. And I was trying to tell her, yes, honey, but that's what they told us, and we didn't know any better. So, But so we, she didn't thought, she thought that was a strange story that, that where babies come from. But anyway, we're thankful for them and pray for their safety and good, healthy babies. All right, we know there's a lot of people tonight that didn't have much joy tonight because they're hurting, their family, some of them are really on drugs and doing things that's causing the family such heartache. We need to, as before we go to bed, let's remember to pray for those people and all of them that's in the storms, having everything you've got blown away. That would be a very traumatic thing. I couldn't imagine that. That would really be rough. So we need to pray for them. Pray for the ones that renders help right now, the ones that are going in harm's way to help these people. So there's always something good that we can do if we look for it and get up and do it. So we hope that you'll find your position and be happy in doing it. Well, our time is come and gone, so from all of us here, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest program. We trust you are blessed every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution of support. Will you become a financial partner of Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? We invite you to send your pledges of support to WLJC, Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.wljc.com. May God bless you.